Right, here we go. Pat, you ready?
Yes.
Now let me see. You need 3 to tie, 4 to win.
Right.
Here we go. Lois Lane said.
A likely story.
Yeah, wait a minute. Wait to hear what Lois Lane said. She said, last night, Superman flew over New York City and got blank. Lois Lane said, last night, Superman flew over New York City and got blank.
That is the worst question in a year.
Now, wait a minute. I'll think about it.
Heard on this show
think
ever.
About it. Last night, just read it to yourself now. Last night, Superman flew over New York.
Lane said, last night, Superman flew over New York City and got... Does that make sense to you?
It makes perfect sense to me.
Well, let me see your answer.
No.
There are many good answers here. Now use the tiny brain God gave you and think of one of the answers.
Pass it down to
you know these two are written. Pass her brain down to you.
Last night,
Superman, you see. You know who Superman is?
Yeah, he's Clark Kent.
That's right, he's that weirdo.
He's got the funny t-shirt.
I mean, he wears a cape.
The S on it.
He wears a cape.
He wears
yes.
The cape.
Yes, he wears a cape.
If you're going to read a question you already read, that's not going to help him. Give us another question.
No, that's the only question. See, this weirdo with the cape is flying over New York City.
Yeah.
Oh!
You see?
And what is it?
And New York City... Well, I can't go any further than that, folks.
Okay.
He's flying over New York City and got blank.
Okay.
That's what we all are. Oh.
Listen, would you like to MC the show? I'll sit here.
No, I'm doing tattletale.
You got it? That's it.
Spelling doesn't
That's very good.
All of us up here are ready, Gene.
All right, I'm just going to check up on you. Not that I don't trust you, because I've seen your work before. Right. And that's perfect. Marvelous answer, you see?
Oh, well, if you like it.
I finally got the idea. Just like pulling teeth to get you people
right. Well, I got the idea. I'm faster than what's her
name. All
right, let's go. But not in remembering names.
Can I have some more paper?
No, just right on the other side. Okay, here we go. Pat, Lois Lane said, last night, Superman flew over New York City and got...
Mugged,
certainly! I mean, that's a joke they do about New York all the time.
Mugged in the air. That's what I want.
But that's the funny part of it, you see.
No, it's not funny.
He's walking down on 14th Street or something like that.
It's not funny, Raymond.
I don't know. I think it's very funny.
Just because you hear it all the time doesn't make it funny, you know.
Well, it's funny it doesn't happen. I've only been mugged once in New York.
Television is a great media.
Well, I said that Superman got shot down.
Shot down? Well, that's another good answer. Is he mugged or shot down?
Let me hear hers. I can't even read hers.
You can't even? We'll figure it out. Go ahead, Brett.
Superman... got a fairy caught in his cape. No, isn't that a more sensible answer?
Well,
how is
it? Now, wait a minute. We didn't say he was flying around Greenwich Village. We just said he was over Midtown Manhattan, didn't we?
Yeah.
Gary's fly.
That's right. All right, Gary.
So can I.
I just went. New York, they do other things in New York besides get mugged. You know,
sure
they also fly around and get high.
That's what I said.
Flew over New York City and got high.
That's
hi, Gare.
Hey, yeah.
Amanda. Pat, you've got to match your remaining ones to stay in the game. Amanda Blake, may we see yours, please?
No.
I'll show you mine if you'll show me yours.
There's mine. Now show me yours.
Oh, what a dumb answer.
What'd you say?
I just got back from New York and I got smog.
Smog.
So that means Maureen Thompson won the game. There's Mark. What do you got, George?
All right. Congratulations to you. You've got $100. Stand by for a moment or so. We've got to say goodbye to Pat Pollard. Sorry to see you go, Pat.
Thank
How much
you.
Money have you got?
$1,200.
Well, you're going to put that to good use.
Sorry.
Good to meet you, Pat. So long. Okay. Here we are with Maureen Thompson. Now, she's got $100. She's going to try for over $5,000 in a moment or so. But right now, we've got this for you. Here we go. Right in the studio audience. She wants your little girl. How old is your little girl?
Four.
Yeah. And she wants to see me fall down again? I don't remember that. What was... Oh.
This is a four-year-old
kid.
You can't let her down.
Listen, I love your little girl. What's her name?
Christina.
Christina. I'm sorry, Christine, I can't do that again because the last time I did it, I hurt myself. No, you know, at the beginning of the show, when I was lying down there, and I rolled down the stairs like this, and no, no.
Yeah, go ahead, Gene.
One, two, three, go. One. How do you feel about rolling down the stairs? Oh, you got seven kids. You roll down the stairs. Okay, now let's get on with the morning, shall we? We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Down the blank.
Oh, boy.
Now, you know, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. You match the next one, you get $250. And the third, $100. Three celebrities are allowed to help. Whom do you choose?
Richard.
Richard, you are first. Down the...
hatch.
Pretty good.
Brett.
Brett.
How about down the drain?
Down the drain.
Gary.
Down the road.
Down the road. Yeah. I think you got three good ones there. Down the road, down the hatch, down the drain. Which one do you want? Or do you want to give us one of your own?
Down the hatch.
Down the hatch. Well, she's hoping that's up there. That's the one that Richard gave her. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. First, may we see the $100 response? Down the drain is up there. That's the one that Brett gave you. Okay, here we go. Looking for down the hatch. Here is the $250 response. Down the hatch. Congratulations. That's $250 more for you. You got $350 now. What do you think's up there?
Down the river?
Down the tube.
Down the tube.
Down the tube, down the road, down the river. I don't know. Here it
down
is.
Down the line, down the...
Here it is. Down the road. They said that, didn't they? Got a very smart audience out there. Okay, Maureen, you got an additional $250. You're going to play for 10 times that amount now, or $2,500. One celebrity has to be matched in order for you to collect that. Which one will it be?
Richard.
Okay, Richard, you ready? Yeah. You face me if you would, please. Here you go with the $2,500 question. Astro blank. A-S-T-R-O blank. Okay, he's finished. Maureen, what answer do you want to give us which you think will match his?
Ooh.
Astro...
Dome.
Astrodome. That's that place in Houston, right?
Yeah.
Okay, Richard, for $2,500. She says Astrodome will match you. What do you say?
I say roll down the stairs again, Gene. How many children do you have?
Seven children.
Youngest is 13, though, right?
No.
No, the oldest is 13. How old is the youngest?
20 months.
20 months.
That's your story.
Dome!
Dome!
$2,850.
I'm
going to
spend it on myself.
Oh. Okay, Maureen, while you pull yourself together, we'll bring another player out here. So let's all welcome Lisa Puglisi.
Congratulations to you.
Hello there, Lisa.
Hi.
Now, when it stops, you can climb aboard. Lisa, you know Maureen.
Uh-huh.
How are you?
Hey, how are you doing?
She's doing great. She's got $2,850. Lisa, would you tell us a little bit about yourself, if you please?
Okay, I'm from Glendale, California.
Yep.
And I'm in nursing school.
You're in nursing school,
uh-huh.
Yes.
And I love to go horseback riding.
Really?
Uh-huh.
What's my temperature? she'll take my temperature during this commercial, okay? And give you a complete report right afterwards. I got so carried away, I thought we were going to have time to start this game, Lisa, but I guess we don't. But anyway, you want to cool off anyway, Maureen. All right, we'll look forward to seeing both of you ladies next time, same place, and look forward to seeing you next time, whenever that is. You were all just terrific.
What was your temperature?
My temperature was 98.6 degrees.
You should sell.
Gene Rayburn, Match Game 74. Join us next time.
Good.